Greetings out there in YouTube land. In today's video, we're going to run a little experiment to see if the practice of warming up an old amp or radio slowly with a Variac is really worth the trouble. Say we're out roaming the local pawn shops and thrift shops and we come up with this jewel right here, a nice old early 60s Gretsch 6150 amp. God only knows the last time it was plugged in or turned on. But we've been told that if we slowly warm it up with a Variac, it'll be very safe on the components and allow the electrolytic capacitors to reform. But detractors say that we're wasting our time, because with a tube-rectified amplifier such as the Gretsch, as we slowly ramp up our AC voltage, the rectifier is not putting out any B+ until the AC gets up quite high, around 100 volts or so. Then the rectifier is going to put out the B+ at a very high surge, which will completely eliminate any benefits that we thought we were gaining by that slow ramping up of AC. Well, let's see who's right. Well, I thought it might be interesting to actually set up an experiment here where we're going to measure the B+ being produced by the 5Y3 rectifier as I crank up the Variac. Now over here it's going to show what the output is from the rectifier in direct current, and over here will be the alternating current that's being input to the rectifier. There may be glare over here on this screen, and if so, let me show you. Right here is 300 volts of direct current. Okay, of course the needle's down here at zero right now, so hopefully you'll be able to see the needle move even if you can't read the numbers on the dial. Okay, let's switch on the Variac. The knob is set at zero output volts. Notice over here it is registering 1.25 volts of AC being applied to the power transformer and to the rectifier tube. Now let's slowly crank up the AC input until we see some deflection in the B+ output. Right now it's at zero. We're at 18, 20 volts input, 30, I'm starting to see some deflection at about 37 volts. So when the Variac is at 37 volts, if you notice, I'm starting to get some B+ output from the 5Y3 rectifier. Now let's continue upward. Let's go up to 50 volts. At 50 volts, I'm running at about 160 volts of B+ output. Run up to 75. I'm running at about a little over 200, and let's run it all the way up now to 120. Notice that you can't see it up here, the pilot light now is coming on. Starting to get a little tiny hum from the amp. And we're up to 119.8 volts, and I'm running B+ of 300 volts, which would be about right for this chassis. Okay, I'll crank it down. And let's discuss what we've seen. Okay, as you can see, cranking up the voltage gently with the Variac from zero up to 120 volts gave us a very nice slow rise in the B+ output from the rectifier. Now granted, from zero to 37 volts there was no output. So you could probably begin your Variac warm-up at about 30 to 35 volts and then, well, at least with a 5Y3 rectifier, and then crank up to 120 over a period of 15 minutes, an hour, however much time you have. But this would gently reform the electrolytic capacitors and sort of give the components a chance to warm up and start operating again, rather than just throw a pail of cold water in their face and hope to God that they can survive it. I can almost hear the comments now, well, that's all fine and dandy with a 5Y3, but how about with the 5U4? Well, let's find out. I just happen to have this Zenith radio chassis in for repairs. It has four lovely Amperex 6BQ5 output tubes and a fat, juicy 5U4 rectifier. Let's run the experiment on this tube. Okay, here we are set up with a 5U4. We'll turn the Variac down to zero, turn it on. Once again, we get a little over 1 volt. Let's watch the needle and see when it starts to deflect. This will show us the B plus output from the rectifier. Let's see, we're up at 20 volts, no deflection. 30. This is about where the 5Y3 started to deflect. Not yet. Let's see, right at about 48 volts. Notice the deflection, and let's run it up to 120. And we're going to get way over 300. 400. 415 volts of B plus. And I'll crank it back down. Okay, let's try it again with a close-up here on the B plus output, and I'll read off the voltages to you. There's 20, 40, 42, right there, 45. Looks like 45 volts of alternating current is what it takes to wake up a 5U4 and get it to start producing B plus. Well, that's about it for this video. I'm keeping it kind of short and to the point. I think that we've seen that the Variac does indeed work well to gently warm up vintage amplifiers that haven't been run in a long time, and that the output from the rectifier begins much lower than people might lead you to believe. They're telling you 100 volts, that ain't true. It appears to be more like about 35 volts with a 5Y3. So you can initiate your gentle warm-up at about 25 or 30 volts on your Variac, and then crank your amp up to the full 120, slowly and gently, and give your electrolytic capacitors and other components a chance to kind of shake off the dust and start working again for you. Thanks so much for your time and interest. I hope that you stay tuned for future videos, that you subscribe if you're so inclined, that you stay healthy, and stay tuned. Thanks so much. Bye for now. Are you gonna say goodbye to our viewers? You gonna wave goodbye with your tail? No? Nope.